So my name is Florian. I'm a photographer based in Dubai. I've been here for over 15 years, so this is really where I do most of my photography. Usually I cover landscape, cityscape, astrophotography, even aerials, so I don't like to constrain myself. I like to explore all the different domains of photography. So the idea of the Timeblend Dubai project that we're exhibiting here is to expand the medium of photography. So normally when you take an image, it only covers a split second or maybe a few seconds of a certain scene. And I wanted to create something that expands that. So the Timeblend Dubai images are combinations of multiple photos taken at different times of the day, or sometimes even different days. So they showcase the whole transition from day to night in a single final image. That's the idea behind Timeblend Dubai. So the beauty about the Timeblend project is that all the individual images that make up one final Timeblend are obviously real. They're just taken at different times of the day. So the viewer can normally never see that in real life, yet all the individual parts do exist in real life. They're not created out of nowhere or they're not fake. And that's what I try to achieve, something that is realistic but still has a very artistic concept to it that normally the observer can't really see in an environment outside. So most of the images, they cover cityscapes of Dubai. I try to cover both the old and the new parts of Dubai, and also a few natural elements of Dubai's surroundings, for example, the desert or the wadis and the mountains. Here we have an image that shows the clock tower in Dubai, one of the most famous Dubai landmarks from 30, 40 years ago. And this image was taken over multiple days. So actually I went to this location 3 times to shoot different parts of the day. So we have the nighttime, the blue hour, then we have the afternoon time and the morning time, so that the entire spectrum of the day is covered in the final composition. And the images combine obviously a lot of individual images. So this is made out of around 25 individual photos, so that I had different elements that I could use in the final combination. So for example, you have the trails of the cars at night, you have some trails during the day as well, but also a few static cars that are not moving. You have a lot of people that are around the clock tower, for example here, a few people that came back from their shopping, and you have a few clouds up here as well. So all of these elements were combined in the final result. One of the things I like about this image is that it obviously encompasses the concept of time, because it's the clock tower, which fits the idea of this project. And it also shows not only the transition from night to daytime, but also from the old to the new, because you can see Burj Khalifa in the background there. So it kind of has a lot of meaning behind it, and that's why it's one of my favorites, I think. Okay, so as I said, there's a lot of cityscape images among the 14 different images of the exhibition. But I also wanted to cover the nature around the city. And here is one such example. So this is a wadi in Ras Al Khaimah, Wadi Shoka, where the interesting part about the Timeblend aspect is that you can see how the light changes the colors of the mountains. So you have like the strong daylight yellowish color, then the orange brownish later when the sun sets, and the bluish and dark colors during the late evening and nighttime. And the same obviously happens in the sky, where you get the blue color during the day and then you have the stars in the evening. So this is another good example where Timeblend enables the viewer to see how really the environment changes over several hours in a way that normally you can't see when you're just there for a few minutes and you don't have the chance to stay for an entire day like I did, for example. So here's another image of the series that is taken in panorama format, this time of the modern cityscapes of Dubai. So here we have Dubai Marina, the early morning time, midday with the strong sun, then the sunset with the sun in the middle, the evening time, blue hour, and then after the blue hour at night. So this covers the whole spectrum of day to night. And here this was taken on a single day from very early morning till late in the evening, basically over around 14 hours. It's also a combination of around 10 images or so combined to create the effect of the day to night transition, and in addition to have also that little boat here and the sun star in the middle. So when it comes to the processing behind these images, obviously when you create a panorama like this, you end up with 5, 10 or so individual panoramas that you then have to combine to create the effect and the smooth transition from day to night. So The first step behind this is that obviously you edit all the individual images in a way that you're happy with the colors and the contrast. And then you have to overlay all the images on top of each other. And here the second step is that you have to make sure they're exactly overlaid. Because obviously when you take an image like this over multiple hours, especially in a panorama, it's very difficult to have exactly the same composition each time. So the second step is to align the images pixel for pixel basically, so that each photo is in exactly the same position when you combine them into the day to night transition. And the third step is then to create a smooth blend between all the images. So you pick where in the image you want to have your day part, where you want to have the night part, which parts you want to have visible and which parts should not be visible. And you use a process called masking to create that smooth blend so that in the end the result looks like it was actually only one image, even though it's a combination of, in this case, 7 or 8 individual images. So there's 14 images in the gallery, a lot of cityscapes, but also a lot of nature. And I'm really happy that I'm exhibiting them here at Zimzy Gallery. They're still gonna be there till the middle of September. So I'm happy to come by myself as well and give a tour to anyone who wants to learn more about Timeblend. And I hope you enjoy the series.